my point.
Yes,
when you get here today, start moving. When you get here on Wednesday, start moving. Make sure you don't have anything on the bottom of your shoes that's going to prevent you from moving around. So in my email yesterday, and you guys, the voice is still not coming back. I don't feel bad. We're just going to make it happen. It's wonderful. So glad to be here. It's going to be humid this morning. It's going to be warm. You know, I believe that through humidity, we find humility. So in the email yesterday, I mentioned the wonderful things that we see with gracious living. When we choose to not live graciously, we find ourselves in a frenzy and have a sense that life is passing us by. We will never get what we're looking for. In our hearts, I think we know that by rushing and overproducing, we are running away from the real hope of happiness. Here's what I want to say. Does anyone remember what the last line of the email was, other than I'm going to the grocery store? No one read your email?
About the car.
There was an email yesterday afternoon. Email yesterday afternoon.
Joy. I remember that.
Enjoy.
That's all I know.
The enjoy.
Best day ever.
Best day ever. No. Y'all are full of good answers.
But they're all wrong.
You know, a teacher would say there's no wrong question or no wrong answer. However, I want to plant this in your brain this morning. Let's get out of the race and into the grace.
Oh, yes, ma'am, I did see.
Let's get out of the race and into the grace. So when you find yourself this morning throughout the day, maybe you're going to leave here and you have this day that is scheduled with so many things. Step back, take a breath, tell yourself, step out of the race and into the grace. Step out of the race and into the grace. Everybody do that. I want you to physically move your body. Step out of the race and into the grace. Do it one more time. Step out of the race and into the grace. And y'all know I love